Myself, Dr. Suman Kumar Mishra, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, KMC, Language, University. And my total teaching and administrative experience is 14 years, and my total publications, 2 books, 3 edited chapters, and total research publication, 16 research papers, and UGC CARE, Scopus based, and SCI journals, and total conferences attend, international and national, 12, and I've got 5 awards in different areas, and recently 2020 awarded Young Researcher Award by INC Research. And my today topic is very brief, starting from the very basics, data. What is data? Data is the raw facts and figures. It is a meaningless form, right? And suppose that I can say 1997. So what is the meaning of the 1997? It is a number, it is a year, it is a rank, it is a roll number. I can't say, right? Then data is the very smallest things in any subject, in any topics, right? So data is the meaningless forms. And it may be used in any characters. I'm asking the ABC. What is the ABC? ABC is variable, ABC is constant, ABC is company name, ABC is a person name. I can't say. Then data is always meaningless. Then next topic is information. Information is a collection of meaningful and relevant data. And it's always written the meaningful form. Right? Suppose that 1997 is a year. So it is a clear, I am saying that it is a related to the years. And ABC is a company. Company means I am particularly saying that ABC is a company. XYZ is a variable. So it is a very clear that XYZ is a variable. Right? Dictionary. Dictionary arranged in the alphabetical order. Arranged in the ascending order. It is also information. Timetable. Also a collection of the lecture schedules, right? So what, many example of the informations. And next is the knowledge. Knowledge is a collection of meaningful and relevant informations, right? And after collection of the information consists of the judgment is called knowledge, right? Suppose that I'm saying Ram is more knowledgeable than Shyam. So what is the meaning of the Ram? How to more knowledgeable? So means ki Ram in collection of information in relevant field and more collection comparison of the Shyam. Then it is called the knowledge. And next, what are the needs of the informations? Yeah, characteristics of the information. So basically 6 main characteristics of any pure informations. First is the completeness. Information always be complete form, not a it is a partial forms. Given the totally complete form of any information, it is very good and it is a pure information. It is the main characteristics of any information systems, right? I am saying just example. For example, Ram is dash 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 boy. What is the meaning of Ram is boy? It means add the words Ram is knowledgeable and honest boy. It is a complete. The completeness is very important in informations. Second is the action oriented. It is given the any, you take the any action, right? And you take the decision behalf of the informations, right? It means collection of the any information in particular subjects and take the results. You got the first division, you got the second division, you got the third division on the basis of the rankings, right? So it is a action oriented. Second is the conciseness. Conciseness is a particular things covering particular informations, right? Conciseness means not very large data, you have large informations for the particular subject. You suppose your conciseness information is very important in characteristics of informations. And availability, easily available of any informations. Accuracy is more important characteristics in information system. More accurate data return the more accurate results, right? And timeliness, okay, within time complete your informations is called the timeliness. And next slides, it's a base of the flow would be like this. Key first two terms, data warehouse. Data warehouse is a database, advanced database, and data mining is a process. And first, very smallest things is a data. Already explained, data is a raw facts and filtered, and it's a meaningless. And next, collection of data make the informations, and it is called the data warehouse. And data warehouse at present scenario very useful, and it's using in the different emergent areas related to the computer science. And next is the information convert into the knowledge is called the data mining, and it is a process called the knowledge. And next is the decision, and behalf of the knowledge you take the decision. But top to bottom approach, it's increase the size of well volumes, but value always increase the bottom to top, right? The bottom to top approach following the value of any informations. And if a producer wants to know, it means the different cover areas producer to wants. And first is, which are our lowest, highest margin customers, and means ki related to the customers, ki win which products ki comes to the highest margin or lowest margins. And next is points is the ki who customers product my buying my products, it is second points. And third point is the what is the most effective distribution channels related to my products, right? It is more effective and cost effective factors, very important in third points. And next is the key, what are the impacts of the new products, and what are the marketing strategy using my business areas. And next is the what are the effects of revenue, it's a next points. And competitions in at present scenario more competitive, then it's a see the customers competitiveness. And next is the data is everywhere. If you not organize the data, so you suffering from the different type of problems. Then you should collect the systematic and collect the meaningful data in particular manners. And suppose you not manage the data, so then you suffer these type of problems. You face the different type of the problem, and explain in this slides. You suffer the lot of works and unnecessary wastage of energy as well as time. So next slides, how to solve in these problems. So we are using the different classification of the data, primary data collect from the main source without using any data, and second is the secondary data, and third is the territory data, three types of the data. And next slide, discussion on to next sessions.